In Loretto, Pennsylvania, day two of the Northeast Conference Softball Championship is here on NEC Front Row. Game number one on the schedule of three today features the St. Francis Red Flash and the Sacred Heart Pioneers. 1-2 pitch. Ripped into right field. That'll get down for a base hit in front of a diving Jordan Seneca. In to score from third is DeRochers, and Sacred Heart takes a 1-0 lead on the base hit from Kellen Fillmore. 3-2 pitch, misses low for ball four, and that'll be a bases loaded walk, bringing home a run for the Red Flash, make it 2-1 Sacred Heart. 3-2, ground ball hit to shortstop, gobbled up by DeRochers. She throws to third. Out of a tire, Cabell for the first out of the inning. Haley Norton comes in to score on the play. There's Taylor Hoover. Pitch missed, runners going. Throw down to third, gets off the glove of Christian, and coming in to score will be Sierra McKee. A double steal, then a throwing error allows a run to come in, and St. Francis takes a 3-2 lead. The 0-2. Driven high in the air and deep to left field. This one's got a chance and it will go. Home run for Caitlin Christian. And it's now 7-3 Sacred Hearts. Three, two, two outs. Runners go. The pitch lined into center field. This is going to be trouble, and that'll get down and go all the way to the wall. Two runs coming in to score for St. Francis is heading into second with a head first dive is Hoover. And just like that, it's a two-run ball game on a two-run double from Taylor Hoover on a 3-2 pitch going to the opposite field. The pitch. Swing and a drive deep to left. It's gone!
Unbelievable. She got the fastball that she was looking for and absolutely crushes it to left field. It was the exact same pitch that she just missed on the previous pitch, and this one flies out 240 feet to straightaway left field, and St. Francis has come all the way back, Joe. So if you're Smith, you reach back and you see if you got a couple more in that right arm, and if you're Ford, you let it rip and you hope for the best.
Left side, throw to first, and the St. Francis Red Flash are advancing to the championship game as they pull it out. A grand slam from Sierra McKee in the bottom of the sixth inning, sealing a Red Flash victory at 9-7. As we now send it down to the field with Dan Griffin, who's standing by with our Bayer Player of the Game.
Bayer Player of the Game, Sierra McKee. And Sierra, congratulations on that, obviously that big grand slam. Take us a little bit through that at bat.
Well, I know she's a good pitcher. She's just gonna work in and out. She's a really good rise ball. I was swinging for it, 100%. I know all the girls in front of me were too, but I was praying. I thought it was gonna happen, so felt good.
Take us a little bit through that at bat. You've got Orozco coming in out of the pen. I think it was fairly wise of you to let a few of them go by, see if what she had to offer. Was that kind of the game plan, just to take a pitch or two, try to get it in the head of a count, and then sit dead red?
If she threw something play, I was taking it regardless. Like, if I thought I could hit it out, ball or strike, I'm a swing for it.
You have the knack kind of for the big moment. Take us through, would it be the Robert Morris home run last year during the tournament, the slam against New Mexico State, or this one? It's hard to pick what's your biggest moment. You seem to kind of have a knack for the spotlight.
I feel like anyone could have did it, anyone in front of me. I live for that moment. It feels great. I like to put our team up. I like to do what I can.
Well, congratulations. Great comeback win, and sit back and enjoy these next two ones, and we'll look forward to seeing you on Saturday.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
We'll now bring in the winning head coach, Jennifer Patrick Swift. And for the second straight game, coach, you guys showed a lot of resiliency. This one, a little bit longer in the tooth than we saw yesterday.
Yeah, absolutely. We made an adjustment in the box as a team in the last two innings, and it worked. So,
kind of take us through that, because you guys were hitting the ball hard through the first four plus frames, but it looked like you guys were just kind of beating it into the ground. That kind of drop ball from McCann wasn't letting you guys really elevate the ball, and while you were driving it, it was right into a stout Sacred Heart defense.
Yeah, I mean, early in the game from pitch one, we kind of let them do what they want in the box as far as neutral, up, in, out, whatever. And then we were just out in front, throwing our hands, not in a position in the box to get under that pitch to lift it. And so we moved them all to the front of the box, and in the last two innings, and said, use your legs, lift the pitch, and they were just able to get more of a solid barrel on it.
Well, let's talk about the flip side. You have Adrian Smith coming in out of the bullpen. She was absolutely lights out for you guys. And outside of that hit from Sierra McKee, she was one of the stars tonight.
Oh, absolutely. So proud of her. I mean, she came in and she was like, here's my chance. I'm going to run with it. You know, and Abby was her biggest cheerleader in there. And, I mean, I cannot say Adrian. You know, without Adrian today, we're not where we are right now. So I'm super, super proud of her.
Congratulations, Coach. We'll let you enjoy these next two games, and we'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning as you try to make it NEC championships.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
All right. There's your Baylor player of the game and our winning coach, Jennifer Patrick Swift. Back to you guys out in the booth.